Hello everyone and welcome to the second episode of Women in Tech. Today I'm excited to introduce our guest, Archana, a senior delivery solution architect at Databricks. Archana is such a talented woman. She holds like tons of certifications in cloud computing and AI. And she has been my study buddy. We have cracked advanced and professional certifications together. Glad to have you here, Archana.
Thank you for having me.
Sure. To start with, can you tell us a bit about yourself and your journey so far?
Of course. My journey into the world of data was a serendipitous one. It feels as though, it was always meant to be. From the very inception of my career, I found myself immersed in the realm of data, though I didn't really understand its significance at that time. It all began with, Informatica mappings and SQL query tasks during my first job. I had to extract and transform data from multiple sources. And what started as a routine assignment quickly became that fascinating exploration of data manipulation. I clearly remember the satisfaction of joining tables and optimizing complex queries and feeling that excitement each time I accomplished a task and uncovered something new and improved query performance too. So as my career progressed, so did the things I learned, the toolkits. I graduated from ETL processes and SQL to platforms like Alteryx, Power BI, Tableau, and each of these new tools opened up a wide world of possibilities, right? I found myself diving into each one, driven by that curiosity to unlock all of that story hidden within that data. My graph went from like easy to complex in a jiffy. By the way, I've also worked on Gephi, the graph network as well, just a pun.
Interesting. So, like when you look back at the early stages of your journey, is there like, do you recall a project that sparked your your passion to data analytics?
Yeah, I have many, but the one specific one that stands out is I was analyzing customer part ordering behavior for a manufacturing client. I have a major background in manufacturing, and we were using advanced analytics. We discovered patterns in ordering cycles, and that was previously overlooked because we're using all these cool new tools to do it, right? So by analyzing all of this historical purchase data patterns, the seasonal trends, we identified reorder points and potential supply chain bottlenecks. And this entire breakthrough moment came when we presented our findings showing how we could reduce inventory costs by about 15% while maintaining those service levels. Now, our client's procurement team was amazed at how we could transform all of these operations so quickly and easily. And that was kind of the moment I knew I had found my calling. It was also around the time where data tools had become really popular.
And I can relate definitely to that. And I could see how data mining could be like your turning point to data analytics.
True. And I did not stop there, right? All of this learning and passion led me to pursue my master's degree in data science. It was kind of during that time that I had the opportunity to work with cutting edge technologies like Google's Vertex AI, BigQuery, different cloud technologies. And looking back, it's clear that each of these steps in my journey, from those early days of, writing SQL queries and now to all these advanced AI systems, it was leading me towards this very path, right? And advanced AI solutions using Databricks, that was the next exciting chapter for me in my data journey. It opened up like all these new possibilities for large scale data processing and sophisticated applications, especially in machine learning.
And actually, like your journey reflects the spirit of an ambitious person, like transitioning from SQL to data analytics, AI, then like getting a master's degree in data science. So here's like the question that comes to my mind. So what did you learn through the master that you did not know before through your work experience?
Yeah, that's a great question because in the past I had not known anything about Python or Python coding, data science algorithms, its different use cases, right? It was not until I did my master's and actually worked on my first real data science project on supply chain forecasting that I truly appreciated everything I learned.
So another question to you, Archana. So how do you find time to study and prepare for all of those certifications?
Finding time to study while balancing work and personal life, it's definitely challenging. I think something that really works for me is group study. I've joined study groups with my colleagues who are pursuing like AWS certifications or other cloud certifications. We just meet regularly, discuss anything that's complex. And then that only makes the learning process a little more engaging. It helps me stay motivated.
And actually, like together, we recently have cracked or like prepared and passed the Databricks Machine Learning Professional Certificate in just 5 days. So this is the power of the group collaboration.
100%. Self-motivation is the key to my approach, right? I constantly remind myself how this certification will advance my career and just open up new opportunities. I think one other thing I'd like to highlight is goal setting, right? Like I try to break down my certification journey into smaller milestones. And most importantly, I write notes. And then I also focus on sort of learning-driven studies, so a little bit of balance between that theoretical knowledge and a little bit of hands-on practice. I use like the AWS Skill Builder resources or Databricks Academy and, you know, set up my own projects.
Yeah, and I agree definitely with your approach of group study and setting goals, breaking stuff down into like multiple phases. And you know, like Archana, definitely like nowadays with the technology changing so fast, I think this is the best way to stay sane and to stay on track to success.
Totally. What has been your experience with managing time with all these certifications you've achieved?
For me, it's, I think I could like narrow it down to one thing, which is cutting social media. So it's
For sure.
shocking, like when you like how much time we spend like scrolling screens without us realizing it. So as soon as I minimize that time, I won't say like I get it 100% off, but minimize it, I find time to make contributions to my YouTube channel, prepare for certifications, work on initiatives, like all the time in the world. But besides that, like personally, I'm a highly disciplined and organized person. So I stick to my schedule, I stay focused, get things done no matter what.
Yeah, I have to admit, you've been a big motivator for me.
Oh, thank you. Archana, like as a woman from India working in such a competitive environment in the US, what are the main challenges you faced during your journey?
Yeah, I think this is like a tough question. I could write pages on it. But if I had to summarize the gist of it is, over time, I've learned that it's more productive to look at these challenges from more of a general perspective rather than framing it as male versus female, you know? So one of the biggest hurdles I've encountered is the constant need to prove myself. It's always being in a perpetual state of evaluation where your competence is always under scrutiny, where in tech, right? So I remember countless times where I'd worked tirelessly on a project to really feel like I had to justify my contributions every step of the way.
By the way, this is very interesting because my first guest, Rula, also mentioned how like she constantly has to prove herself. Yeah.
Interesting. I wonder if she shares the same about the next challenge I'm going to present, which is being bypassed for promotions, right? So it's frustrating to see others advance while I seem to be stuck in place. So this experience has taught me a really valuable lesson, which led me to reflect on what I truly value and enjoy in my work, just beyond, you know, climbing the corporate ladder. I realized that one, obviously enjoy what you do, and two, self-promotion, we shouldn't shy away from it. It's effective. It's important for career advancement. So by learning to articulate my accomplishments and then my unique value proposition, I began to differentiate myself and then increase my visibility within the organization I'm working in.
I share your view about like self-promotion, and I truly think it's very important skill for career growth. But my question to you is, how do you find your voice in a room full of assertive personalities?
Oh, again, that is such a hurdle. I still face difficulties today. In the beginning, I often felt overshadowed or ignored in meetings, but I've learned that this only changes when you build your own confidence. You know, it's not about being the loudest person in the room, but about speaking up with conviction when you have something valuable to contribute. In this area, I still have a long way to go, but I try every day.
I totally agree with you. And I would like to hear from you a word of wisdom. What do you advise women who are pursuing a career in tech?
Oh, I'd like to keep it simple. Don't give up. Keep learning and growing. Look at these challenges from like that broader perspective, not just gender issues. You have to prove yourself, do that self-promotion. But what truly matters to you, just beyond promotions, is building that confidence to make your voice heard. Take on new challenges. Don't overanalyze it. And learn to promote yourself effectively. Remember to also take breaks and recharge when needed. I think that's super important for women.
Okay, thank you. And in your opinion, what steps can men take at the workplace to create an inclusive and fostering environment where women can thrive and participate equally in tech industry?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is to be empathetic. Be aware of those unique challenges faced by women around you. Create a space for diverse voices, perspectives, and offer equal opportunities based on merit. And then support your colleagues' professional growth. Remember, inclusivity technically benefits everyone, leading to more innovation, better ideas, and better problem solving.
I could not agree more. Okay, Archana, that we have learned about your inspiring journey, I would like to learn more about like your hobbies, interests. What do you do outside working hours when you are not working?
One boring hobby, but I really like, is that I'm actively involved in women's tech groups. I participate in these groups. It not only so supports my professional growth, but it helps me contribute and create a more inclusive environment. So I enjoy that.
Oh, cool. And by the way, this is how Archana and I met. We met through Women in Data when I was like searching for a study partner. We just clicked, and since then we have been like studying together.
Yeah, couldn't agree more. Noor is outstanding. Other than that, outside of work, I've discovered a passion for traveling, trekking that offers some fresh perspectives from time to time, some physical challenges. And then I also enjoy reading, of course. I enjoy playing board games with my kid. And woodworking has become a new rewarding hobby. I really enjoy using that saw and creating something tangible with my hands.
Well, so you have the set equipment to do with work?
No, actually go to the stores and use the set equipment.
Okay, nice. Okay, cool. Thank you so much, Archana. I truly enjoyed this chat with you and learning more about your inspiring journey in the tech industry. And I'm looking forward, by the way, to crack another certificate with you soon.
It's been a pleasure. Really enjoy working with you.
Thank you so much. And at the end, I would like to say that there are many theories about how to support women in tech and how to create the best work environment. But the fact that the women participation in AI is still below 30%, that shows that those theories are still not effective yet. We come from different backgrounds, and we have a lot to learn from each other to build an inclusive work environment. And I think the best thing we can do is simply to listen. Just hear up the other person's perspective and challenges before jumping to solutions and conclusions. We learn a lot through listening than when we do talk. And today I have learned a lot through the inspiring journey of Archana that she shared with us. Thank you so much. To our followers, would like to hear your thoughts. And see you on the next episode of Woman in Tech with another successful woman. Until then, stay safe. Salam.
Thank you.